Hey, Vol fans, I'm Evan Ellis, and this is Vol Access, Tennessee men's basketball. It's been a rough first week of conference play for Tennessee, and it's not going to get any easier as the Vols have a trip up I-75 to tangle with the defending national champion Kentucky Wildcats on Tuesday night. Vol Access has everything you need to know about the matchup at Rupp Arena, so here's the starting lineup. We'll have the top three plays from the games against Ole Miss and Alabama. We talked to Vol players about the rivalry with Kentucky, and associate head coach Tracy Webster previews John Calipari's Wildcats. But first, here's Vol Access's Sam Scott with the top three plays.
Thanks, Evan. Here's the top three from last week's matchup with Ole Miss and Alabama. Number three, Jarnell Stokes says, "Dunk you very much, Colonel Reb."
Here's Stokes with the double team, takes it on the lane and slams.
Number two, Yenny Nakanjula with the power hook.
For the key. Penetrates, pull up, free throw line, jump shots, way short. Mackenjula gets the rebound. Goes up, throws it up and in. Woo! Yemi with a little hook shot on the baseline.
And your number one play. Freshman Armani Moore has a breakout performance in Tuscaloosa.
Cooper feeling it, drives against Kenny Hall, goes in, and the shot blocked out of bounds by Moore. In the first half, let's see here. In the corner, Moore's got an open look from three, and he hits.
Buddy.
From Adolph Rupp and Ray Mears at the old Stokely Athletic Center, to Kentucky native Chris Lofton going home and putting on a show. Passionate fans have filled arenas and gymnasiums to watch Tennessee and Kentucky play basketball hundreds of times. Vol Access sat down with current Vol players to get their take on the rivalry with the Wildcats.
Tennessee's oldest and most played series among SEC opponents is with the Kentucky Wildcats. The two teams first met in 1910 and have clashed 214 times throughout the years. No program in college basketball has logged more wins over Kentucky than Tennessee. With the first meeting this season in Lexington, the Volunteers will travel to a hostile Rupp Arena as they begin the next chapter in the storied rivalry.
What sets up there? You know, you got the Duke, North Carolinas, and things like that. But especially in the SEC, I think that's one of the biggest rivalries in the SEC.
I'd definitely say it's pretty far up there with the big ones. I definitely know I'll put it up there. I know it's always been a big game every time they played here or there, so I just know both the times we played this year are going to be big.
Growing up in East Tennessee, being a UT fan all my life, I understand what that rivalry means, and it's a big deal. And so, I'm glad to get to take part in that. The Kentucky Loyal, they got a lot of fans, and they really do well to support their fans. They're always going to hassle you, but that's kind of what makes it fun.
They come in packs. They came in pretty big numbers last year, so they're definitely obnoxious. I'll tell you that much.
It's tough going in there to play. It really is. It's one of the toughest places in the SEC, I think, to go in there to play. But it also makes for, if you get a win in there, that it's twice as sweet. It's definitely one of those memories that you'll look back on in years to come and can tell your kids and grandkids about.
For Vol Access, I'm Leslie Saloom.
Now let's head down to Leslie Saloom, who is standing by with associate head coach Tracy Webster to preview the Wildcats.
Thanks, Evan. I'm here with associate head coach Tracy Webster to talk about the game against Kentucky on the 15th. This is the first time we get to play the defending national champions, but this year it's virtually a whole new team, brand new starting five.
Yes, definitely. They have a whole new team, but they're still very talented. Their point guard play is still good. They have guys on the wing that can really play. And then, I know they lost Anthony Davis, but they have a big guy. Noel, he actually does a great job of blocking shots as well. So they're very talented. We still have to come ready to play. And I think our guys will be up for it.
Now, as you mentioned, Noel is a big guy. Who's been really good for them this season, as well as Poitras and Colley Stein. But can you talk about a little bit about their guard play and Goodwin and Harrow?
Well, Harrow, with him being a transfer set out last year, he's done a great job coming back after sitting out a couple games. Um, He played well against Vandy. Does a great job of taking care of the basketball as well as, you know, creating shots for himself and others. And then you have Archie Goodwin, who does a really good job of attacking the basket. So he's a very, you know, seemed like a very experienced player, especially with Harold not playing early on. He played some points, so very versatile and does a great job for him.
Now, we're traveling to Rupp Arena, probably a very volatile arena, especially if you're in orange. So what do you think the keys will be for us to be successful there?
Well, I think we have to play Tennessee basketball. Not, you know, you can't allow a team to speed you up when you're on offense. And then defensively, you have to do a good job of protecting the paint and taking away fancy plays like lob dunks and things like that behind the back passes into a three-point shot, because those guys get up for those type of plays. And we have to try to take that crowd out of it. But at the same time, if that crowd get into it, we have to be poised enough to, you know, do what we do and move the basketball and make sure we take good shots.
All right, well, be sure to tune in ESPN January 15th, 7 p.m.
The game against Kentucky airs Tuesday night at 7 on ESPN. Ball Network coverage will begin at 6:30 on your local Ball Network affiliate or at utsports.com/allaccess. For more information on the Vols road trip, visit utsports.com and follow at Vol Hoops on Twitter. For Sam Scott and Leslie Saloom, I'm Evan Ellis. This has been Vol Access, Tennessee men's basketball.